This is part two of the lecture number one, and in this part I will present a number of different file formats, data file formats, that are commonly used in astronomy and in other sciences. And we start with the most simple example. This is just an ASCII file, a plain text file. This is the most intuitive data format, and it has the big advantage that it is human readable if you just open the text file. It is pretty friendly in terms of compressibility. So using algorithms like ZIP or gZIP allows a high compression rate in these plain text files. They are usually pretty fast to process, and it's very simple to access them and open them and get an idea about their contents. They come in different form and incarnations, particularly if they contain for each observation a number of variables. And one common example is the so-called CSV format. CSV here stands for comma-separated variables. Every row in this file corresponds to one observation, and every variable is then listed and separated by a variable. The big advantage here is that it's easy to mix different kinds of variables. You can mix text or string variables, numerical variables, categorical, everything, because you cannot confuse them because of the commas. You can also choose different separating strings. For example, there is also TSV, tabulator separated variables, and others. Plain text files also come in fixed format, which means that certain variables, certain entries are always at the same position in the file, or that different variables are always separated by a certain number of empty spaces or two tab separators and so on. And this might also change during the same file. And here I give you an example of a complicated setup of a text file. These are usually somewhat more complicated to read in and read out if you transfer them to other people, to other systems, to other software, and so on. And there are variations or mixtures of the above fixed format and free file formats, like I show in this example. Disadvantages of this kind of file format is that it's very difficult to include structured information, to include dependencies between different parts of the entries and so on. It's also difficult to include sufficient explanatory information. This is usually called meta information, and this is the description of the data itself. So what is the content of the file? Where does it come from? Who is responsible for it? Who is to contact, for example, to get more information, and so on, which is very difficult to include without disturbing the form of the file content. Then there are binary files, which technically every computer data file is. The difference to the ASCII files or the text files that I showed you before is that in binary files they use the full byte range, while the actually readable characters corresponding to, for example, the characters on your keyboard are only limited to the lower half of the full byte. so values between 32 and 126. As a result, if you open a binary file in a text editor, it tries to convert each byte, so each group of 8 bits, into a single character, and the display will look actually pretty garbled and unreadable. Usually you need a certain application, a certain software to actually display the contents of this data file, because you need to know what byte is what kind of information. An advantage of binary files is that the information content is higher because they use the full 8-bit space. So with a lower number of bits you can include a higher information density, which makes it very rapid in reading in and writing out, for example. As an additional result, they also usually have smaller file sizes, and it's much easier to combine different data types which within a single file, for example text and images, where an image is a large collection of bytes, for example, and so that's much more easy to combine. However, the actual decoding is somewhat more complicated and system dependent. As an example, I mention here the differences between little and big endian encoding. So how many bytes are actually used to correspond a number, how are negative numbers actually encoded, and so on. What is the meaning of the leading byte, for example? Okay, these were the two very general file formats, and this brings us now to more specialized data formats, and we start with astronomy. And the most common data format used in astronomy is the so-called FITS data format. FITS stands for Flexible Image Transport System, and it's abbreviated, so it has the file extension FITS, FIT, FTS, and so on. It's described in a series of papers from the 80s, and it is designed as an open standard defining a digital file format that's been used for storage, transmission, and processing of data that is formatted as an n-dimensional array, usually a two-dimensional image or as a table. So it's also very commonly used to store image information from cameras and so on. An important feature here is that the FITS format contains a so-called header information. That's the part of the FITS file that contains the metadata, where all the detailed information on what is contained into this FITS file is stored. And in an astronomical example, this could be what are the coordinates that this image, for example, has been observed, what coordinate system has been used, when was the data taken, what telescope has been used, what has been already done to the data, has there been any data reduction steps before the data is stored here, what are the units of the coordinate system, and so on and so on. To actually access a FITS file, you need usually a certain software that is able to digest the information. However, you can also look at the contents of a FITS file with a text viewer, and then the beginning of this file consists of the header, which is stored in ASCII in text format. So even though you cannot look at all the at the data itself, you can read the metadata with just the text viewer. Another very specialized data format is the so-called HDF format, which stands for Hierarchical Data Format, and the most recent version here is data format number 5. The file extension is HDF5 or .h5. It is more flexible than FITS data. It supports n-dimensional data sets where each individual element can again be a very complex object like another table containing a list of another tables and so on. It is self-describing in the sense that it allows to store all the data and all the metadata just in this file container. And it's optimized for high performance input and output and allows for very large files, much larger, for example, also than memory capacities of a individual PC, for example. The organization of data in an HDF file can be visualized similar to the file formation, file organization on a computer, so similar as a file system. You have a root from which you can organize your files in certain directories, and each directory can then hold individual files or other directories and so on. And you can link also a certain object such that it appears in multiple directories and so on. So here again, the data is then the actual raw data values, and the metadata gives you all, should give you all the information, for example, the dimension of the data, the units of the actual individual data elements, all the necessary information that I need to understand what the data is. There are many other data formats. There is a somewhat older version of the HDF format, which is HDF4. There is NetCDF, JSON, XML, the Hadoop distributed file system for big data applications, and so on and so on. These file formats usually depend a lot on the scientific field that you are working on and also on the technical requirements of the data and the data processing